Hey, boys, we're on the air.
Time to enter the Co-Zone with your host, Rich. Hope my jokes are as funny as my wardrobe, Co's. And classic Three Stooges shorts. And if it's slapstick you're looking for, remember, Curly's woo-woo-woo backwards is...
Ow, ow, ow!
Okay, just stay calm. Everything's going to be fine. Explain to me again what happened. Okay, so the saw was dragged across the top of your head, and what damage was done? The saw lost 13 teeth. Well, get it to a dentist as soon as possible. Well, as usual, it's a busy night here at the Stooge Crisis Prevention Hotline. Here, when slapstick problems arrive and you find it difficult to cope, a quick call brings support and help that'll get you through these hard-to-face Stooge problems. Stooge Crisis Hotline. Oh, okay, calm down. You've just been poked in the eyes. Okay, now tell me what with? A broom handle, a thumb? What? Two fingers? Okay, now the first thing you want to do is briskly massage the facial area with both hands. Yeah, both hands. And then you promote rhythmic breathing by making a sort of woo, woo sound a lot faster than I just did it, though. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right. You'll be fine. No, not Larry Fine. So whether your problems stem from stress, family disasters, or, as demonstrated in tonight's Stooge Shorts, alcohol, the Stooge Crisis Hotline can help you overcome life's slapstickier moments. Just dial 555 oh 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 oh. Stooge Crisis Hotline, you've just had a handful of hair pulled out? Okay, calm down. Now, to get blood flowing to the affected area, you've got to do some rapid up and down head movement. You know, the sort of thing where you move your head up and down and side to side. Very carefully, moving it.
Oh, whiplash.
Stay tuned for the first of our Stooges and Spirits themed Stooge Shorts right after these messages.
And then maybe try to eat some pancakes that are actually potholders.
Well, that about slams the lid on the Co-Zone for another week here. We're glad that you tuned in to see these Stooge Shorts, and we'll have more of them for you next week. Once again, if you'd like to send us your picture, your kitchen magnets, or anything else you have lying around the house, just send it to this address, the Co-Zone, care of Fox 32, 205 North Michigan Avenue, Chicago.
Irwin.
No, once again, it's Chicago, Illinois, 60601 Market. Attention, Rich Co's. We'll be glad to hear from you. And I think I'll wind up this week with another important story for the 90s, something that'll teach us all a lesson, because God knows we all need to learn a lesson. This one is about Geraldo, the singing bullfighter. Many years ago in Spain, there was a very famous bullfighter who was well known for the fact that once he was finished with the bull, he would slice it up and eat it. He was the most famous matador in Spain of all time. But one day, he walked out into the big arena there, the bullfight arena, did his thing with the bull was dead, he sliced it up and ate it in its entirety. And once he had consumed the entire bull, he stood up, faced the crowd, and began to sing. He turned around and sang to the crowd. Suddenly a man rose up in the crowd, took out a gun, and shot him. The bullfighter fell down dead. Now, what is the moral of this story? Very simple. When you're full of the bull, keep your mouth shut. Yep. Something I could certainly afford to learn at this point. Listen, I'll see you next week and every morning on WCKG. See you next week. I'll keep my mouth shut. Thank you. Look, I'm sore.
Everybody!